You're listening to Bodhi Light Tales, the podcast for mindful people on the go. Hello, this is Miao Guang. Today's Bodhi Light Tale is A Bowl of Noodles. Once upon a time, there was a high school student named Annie, who lived with her mother. One thing she feared most coming home from school was her mother's non-stop gossiping and complaining. One day, Annie came home after a bad day at school. She opened the door, and there her mother was, in the living room, waiting for her. Annie just wanted to go straight into her room. But her mother called out, "Aren't you going to say hello? How was school today?" Before Annie could answer, her mother said, "I just got off the phone with Mrs. Cooper. She told me her daughter cooked dinner last night, and her son is helping with the gardening and planning their family trip." Annie rolled her eyes and slowly edged towards her bedroom. However, her mother continued, "Are you listening to me? You should be helping me with household chores too. You never cook, you never do anything for me." Upon hearing this, Annie couldn't hold herself back anymore. She cut in and shouted in frustration, "I've had enough. Your gossiping and complaining must stop. I won't take this anymore. I'm leaving." Annie stormed out of the house, determined to get as far away as possible. Having spent hours walking around town, Annie was tired and it was already late. She sat down at a bus stop and then realized that her stomach was rumbling. She could smell food nearby, and as she looked around, she saw a noodle shop just around the corner. Annie quickly got up and walked over. She looked at the menu, and just as she was about to order a bowl of noodles, she reached into her pocket. With great disappointment, Annie realized she forgot to bring her purse. The shop owner welcomed Annie and asked, "Young lady, what would you like?" Annie shook her head and looked down. She thought to herself, "Why did I forget to bring money? What am I going to do? I am so hungry, I am not even sure if I have energy to get home." The owner politely asked again, "Would you like some noodles?" Highly embarrassed, Annie answered, "Yes, I would love some noodles, but I left my money at home." The owner saw how worried Annie looked and said, "Well, you know what? You're in luck. You are my last customer today. Your noodles will be on the house." He then began to cook the noodles, adding extra vegetables and broth to the bowl. When the noodles were served, Annie was so hungry, she couldn't wait to eat. As she ate a few mouthfuls, tears began trickling down her cheeks. The owner, who kept watching her, asked, "You don't like the noodles?" Annie quickly wiped her tears and replied, "No, not at all. I just thought of my mother. She never has anything good to say to me. She always complains and compares me with other people. Mostly, she either criticizes me for something I didn't do or blames me for what I did. I am never good enough for her. You, on the other hand, are so kind to me. And you don't even know me. I feel really touched. Thank you so much." On hearing what Annie just said, the owner shook his head and replied, "Well, I've only given you a bowl of noodles, yet you feel so touched. But have you ever put yourself in your mother's shoes? How many meals has she cooked for you? I'm sure that despite her complaints, she means well." Shocked by his words, Annie realized she had been thoughtless and selfish. She felt bad for snapping at her mother without understanding her true intentions. After finishing the noodles, she thanked the owner and quickly made her way home. As she neared home, she saw her mother had been waiting for her by the door. Looking anxious, she asked Annie, "Where have you been? I was worried sick. Anyway, the food is cold now. I'll heat it up for you. So come in and have dinner." This story highlights the hearts of all parents. Many parents wish to express their love and care towards their children in the best possible ways. Some express through giving advice like, "Do well at school and make us proud," or "Do more exercise and look after yourself," or "Don't go out partying too much," or "Don't stay up too late, sleep early," and so on. In this story, Annie's mother believes she's showing Annie how much she cares for her. However, Annie felt she was just complaining. This is an instance of mutual misunderstanding. How can parents show their care without sounding inconsiderate? How can children express their thoughts and feelings effectively? Truth be told, nobody can really get the best of both worlds. As parents, caring for our children is no doubt a blessing. However, the needs and feelings of our children must be taken into account. It is vital to give them time and space to find themselves. It is equally vital to let them know we are there for them when they need us. As children, understanding the true intentions of our parents is just as important. We must put ourselves in their shoes and ask ourselves often, what have we done for our parents lately? Have we shown them enough care? Even more so, this self-reflection extends to our family as a whole. What about the rest of our family? Have we shown them that we do care? Just as Venerable Master Hsing Yun says, as parents, we should be perfectly willing to raise our children. As teachers, we should be perfectly willing to educate our students. As students, we should be perfectly willing to listen and learn. As sons and daughters, we should be perfectly willing to love and care for our parents. This is Miao Guang. Thank you for listening to Bodhi Light Tales. Subscribe to us and have stories delivered to you every week. May your day be filled with happiness and wisdom.